Hey everyone, Austin here again with another Let's Play video. Today it's going to be Super Luigi Brothers, which is included in the NES Remix Pack for the Wii U. It's a part of NES Remix 2. This was 2014. It was basically a version of the NES Super Mario Brothers, but with Luigi and Luigi physics, and the game played in reverse. So this should be a pretty fun Let's Play. This is going to be a relatively short one. I'm not going to go through the entire game. I am, but I'm not. I plan on doing the warp zone trick this time because you guys have seen me play through Super Mario Brothers countless times, and it'll probably take about an hour to go through the whole game normally, so I'm just going to do the warp zone trick to make this a 15 or 20 minute playthrough. So, this is really cool. What we have to do here is actually go into the NES Remix 2. So while that's happening, as usual, I'd like to give a big shout out to the current Patreon backers and YouTube Super Chatters. So they're going to flash by the screen as we do this. So thank you guys for your continued support. But yeah, this is actually a pretty cheap pack. This is a compilation of what was originally two eShop exclusives, but now you can get them both together on a single disc. And the single disc will probably cost you $20 or less. It's not an expensive game, at least at this point in time. And it is really nice because you get Super Luigi Brothers as well. This is a really cool package to begin with. We'll probably do a dedicated live stream of this sometime because I actually haven't put much time into NES Remix, but a little bit I have. It's been a lot of fun. So there's a lot of really cool stuff that happens in these. You can also get NES Remix Ultimate on 3DS. It does not have Super Luigi Brothers from what I was able to find, but I think it does have another variation of the first Super Mario Brothers. So something to look for if you want to play that on the 3DS. So let's go ahead and just jump into Super Luigi Brothers. Now, I do have a couple complaints with this. For one, the graphics are extremely, extremely soft. It's almost as if like they took the composite signal and just upscaled it. It's really, really fuzzy. So the gameplay is not going to look as sharp as it probably normally should. And as far as I'm aware, there's no way to turn the filter off or anything like that to make it light, nice and razor sharp and whatever. Also, I've noticed there's quite a bit of input lag in this as well. So, you know, that's going to definitely throw me for a loop as well, but still, we're going to go ahead and try to go through this anyway. So let's go ahead and hit the start button and play some Super Luigi Brothers. Now, every time I play this, I'm always thrown off a little bit because everything's in reverse. Not only does the input lag and whatnot throw me off and the graphics smoothing, but the fact that I'm going right to left really, really throws me for a loop. It's just, it takes a little while to adjust to, and I think anyone that's played a lot of the original Super Mario Brothers will probably experience the same thing, where it just they don't know what to do with it. It just takes a while to get it adjusted to. Also, Luigi's higher jump is also kind of interesting too, because I've played so much of the original Super Mario Brothers, I'm not used to his high jump. Now, his jumping ability in this, from what I understand, is matched with the original Famicom Super Mario Brothers 2. So if you're used to that, it probably won't take you a long time to get the hang of this. But for me, I haven't played much of the original Famicom Super Mario 2 in a very, very, very long time. But that's also something that we're going to have to do sometime soon as well. As we've sort of been on a Mario kick lately. Actually, we've been playing quite a few Mario games in recent times, so maybe this is the year of Mario on my channel. No, I'm just kidding. it probably seems like that so far, but trust me, guys, we are going to start mixing things up a little bit more. It's just, it's playing lots of Mario stuff recently has worked out quite well for me. It's something I've wanted to do, and you guys have enjoyed it as well. So let's actually go ahead and get this Fire Flower. Again, we're just doing the Warp Zone tricks. I'm not trying to rush through these levels super quickly. Also, there are a couple things here in this game. Is for one, the A button on the Wii U controller is what lets you run. What lets you jump, and the B button is what lets you run. Which is, you know, that's how it's mapped on an original NES controller. But on the Wii U, the buttons are tilted up to the right, and I'm not really a big fan of that. To be honest with you, I wish I could map it like on a Super Nintendo, where it's the Y button is the run button and the B button is the jump button. It's just much more natural from my thumb positioning. And it's just, it's much nicer to me. It's how I like to play Super Mario Maker, and I'm pretty sure you can map the controls that way on the Virtual Console versions of Super Mario Brothers. Yeah, you can. You can remap your buttons on the VC Wii U titles, which is nice. So But not on Super Luigi Brothers, unfortunately. So, now I am sort of getting used to the input lag here. What I'm starting to do is I'm basically starting to press my buttons early. So, sort of, look ahead, see what I have to do, then press the buttons slightly before I hit a platform or something like that. Or I need to shoot out a fireball or something like that. Mario Maker has a similar issue with input latency. So if you've played a lot of original Super Mario Brothers on, say, a CRT, and then you go and you play Mario Maker on Wii U on an HDTV, it's like, whoa, this is completely different. This is very, very laggy. You do get used to it in the case of Mario Maker, and in this you can get used to it as well. So here's our last little warp zone area. Ooh, that's actually not good. I might have to kill myself because I'm a dummy. The whole reversal threw me for a loop again. I actually jumped up and hit the wrong block, and I could have gotten that if I was small Mario, but as big Mario or Luigi, I keep forgetting we're Luigi, we're not Mario. And that actually made me confused too, because when you get the fire flower in this, you go big like you're Mario. And you turn the same colors as Mario does, so Luigi starts looking like Mario even though he's a Luigi. It's kind of interesting that they weren't able to change that, but I'm guessing this is some form of emulation, and that probably would have required a lot more trickery to get working. But being big Luigi there, I wasn't able to squeeze through that that little gap, unfortunately, and so I basically had to be small Luigi. Alright, so this is World 8. And we'll see how this goes. I've actually never beaten this version. Normally when I do these Let's Plays, I try to practice the games that I Let's Play, but I've played so much of the original Super Mario Brothers over the years that I figured I could just jump into this one blind. And I am doing an absolutely terrible job of not taking damage here, but so not a huge deal, considering we've only died once. And it was an intentional death, unfortunately, but it looks like we've just died twice, and I actually wasn't paying attention. I didn't see my life count there, but that's all right as well. So if you've never played Super Mario Brothers, you'll notice that I'm just running over those tiny gaps. That was always a really cool feature back in the day. A little bit of an advanced strategy, sort of, in a way. But as long as you've got enough momentum built up as you're holding in the run button, you can just basically glide over one block wide gaps, which has always been nice. So, although we're not going to do that right here, and Luigi's higher jump is really throwing me off as well. It's really, really throwing me off. Something I've got to get used to still. I probably should have done a practice run or two before doing this Let's Play, like I usually do, but I ended up doing this, like, hours before I would normally have it posted on, like, Patreon or something like that, so I've just been busy this weekend and these last couple of weeks, and so I haven't been able to practice as many games as I wanted. I've actually been practicing stuff for, like, longer playthroughs on live streams, but not as much practicing stuff for, like, the Let's Plays and whatnot, so but yeah, alright, so we're actually getting close to the end of the game here, and this level is actually usually not too bad for me, especially with Luigi here, and I'm gonna skip, let's go ahead and get that 1-up, because I don't trust myself, really. We'll just let the 1-up go across the top here, and we'll try to grab it on the way down. But yeah, NES Remix is something I definitely want to put some time into. I'm going to skip that mushroom. And since we're Luigi here, I can probably just, you know, jump across things that I probably wouldn't be able to jump across before with just Mario, which is pretty cool. But yeah, NES Remix itself, this was a really nice bonus, but the game itself seems really, really fun. And I definitely want to put some time into it. I've owned it for several years now. I mean, it was released in 2014, I believe, as the double pack. Was it 2014, or did the double pack come out a little bit later? I think it might have been 2014, or maybe it might have been a little bit later. Title screen says 2014, release dates online for NES Remix 2 say 2014, but I'm not sure about the NES Remix pack as an entire pack. But yeah, it seems really fun. I played it, I actually downloaded the first NES Remix when it came out on Wii U back in 2013. As the Wii U is pretty much my primary console by that point. This was before I had gotten an Xbox One And so I actually bought some of the bought some of the downloads back in the day when they were relatively current, and I did put a little bit of time into it back then, and it seemed like it was a lot of fun. Oops, I thought I was just far enough over to the right to be able to dodge that, but apparently not, and we only have 4 lives left, so I do have to be relatively careful here. But yeah, we'll try to put some time into NES Remix. We'll probably do what I'm going to start calling blind streams, where I basically play games on stream that I haven't really put much time into before. So they're going to be live streams that don't involve me practicing before doing the streams. Now, okay, this is the right one. Cool. So there are two sets of platforms like these, where you've got Hammer Brothers that you have to deal with, and each one has a power-up in it. So this used to be one of the hardest levels for us. Oops, crap. This used to be... I'm going to kill myself again, actually. This used to be one of the hardest levels for us growing up because of the Hammer Brothers. And at the very end, there are a couple of stretches where you have to get past Hammer Brothers that are on the same level as you. And that's... one of the few times in the game where you have to actually do that, and it's actually quite challenging to get past them when they're on the same level as you. When they're above you like this, it's not too bad, but the easiest way to get past them when they're on the same level as you is to have the Fire Flower. And the reason I killed myself here is it was going to make it really difficult to get past them without the Fire Flower. And when you try to bop them like that, it, you know, you really need to be careful, because what can happen is what happened with me, where, you know, I bop the bricks, but they move over just at the right time, and they avoid getting knocked off. So let me go ahead and do this right here and snipe him. But with the Fire Flower, we can now snipe the Hammer Brothers from a distance like this. So, and it makes this part so much easier. So if you get to this point and you have a bunch of lives and you're just small Luigi or you're small Mario, you can kill yourself. Just make sure you play the first half right so you can get yourself the Fire Flower and then just be done with the second half much easier. Also, going into the final castle with the Fire Flower makes the final castle a lot easier as well, because there is an underwater section where you've got bloopers that kind of try to come after you underwater. You've also got a lot of Goombas. You also have more Hammer Brothers that you have to deal with in person. And then you've also got Bowser at the end, who is a lot easier to beat when you can snipe him with fireballs. So I'm going to take it relatively safe here just because I don't really trust myself at this moment. But we're going to go ahead and go down this tube. And it's going to pop us out back up here. Now, we've got Buzzy Beetles right here. I don't really want to mess with those guys. They can't be killed unless they get knocked off a pit, or they slam into each other when they're both bouncing around after you've hit them once. So, and there's going to be a block... Oh, are you kidding me? Did I miss it? Oh, I'm such an idiot, man. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so the reversal of the game screen threw me off again. So things that are normally on the left, I keep thinking they're still on the left, but they're actually on the right now. So there it is. That's what I missed the first time. Fortunately, on the castle here, these sections do loop, but you just want to find the right pipe to go in. And this is why I said, like, it takes a little while to get used to the reversal of the screen orientation, much longer than you would expect, to be honest with you. So there are the bloopers, and again, they're a lot easier to take out when you've got the Fire Flower. Now, if you're just small Mario or small Luigi, you don't actually have to, try to go over them or something like that. You can, in fact, just walk on the bottom of the screen, and they'll never come down and touch you. They never come all the way down far enough to touch you when you're small Mario or Luigi. And there is the last Hammer Brother, and for Bowser here, what we're going to do is just try to snipe him from a distance. Just like so. And that's the easiest way to take care of the final level in the game. Wow, this Let's Play is actually going to be shorter than I thought. We're only at 15 minutes right now. So that wasn't even like 15 minutes of gameplay. It was like 5 minutes of talking in the beginning and then 15 minutes of gameplay. But, yeah, so that's the easiest way to take out the final castle. Now, if you're small Luigi or small Mario, it's considerably more difficult. Because not only do you have to get past the first, 85% without taking a hit, but then you got to get past the Hammer Brother at the end. Which the best way to do that is generally to wait for him to jump and then run under him. But it's a very small window to do that, and you've got to be better at the game to make that happen consistently. And then Bowser himself, generally speaking, it's the same thing. You're probably going to run under him. Bowser throws a lot of hammers at the very end on Castle 8, and he also does it on Castle 7 and probably 6 as well. So that's it's tough to jump over him like that. But if you're Big Mario with the Fire Flower, it's so much easier. You can just, play safe, snipe from a distance and whatnot. So now, just like the original Super Mario Brothers, if we wanted to, we could press the B button to actually skip through different worlds and whatnot. It's basically hard mode now. So if we actually play the game again, which we're not going to, I'll just demonstrate it a little bit. It is a harder skill mode now. So you're going to have more enemies and whatnot. Certain enemy types have been adjusted. So Goombas in the game are now going to be Buzzy Beetles. And they're going to walk across the screen, I think, a little bit faster. So let's see what we've got here. Some of these levels might actually not be changed all that much. But others, especially ones with lots of Goombas, will be considerably different. So, no Goombas so far. So that means no Buzzy Beetles yet. And yeah, it looks like that's pretty much it. So, going through Loop 2 is always fun as well. If you're playing Super Mario Brothers or Super Luigi Brothers, well, not really Super Luigi Brothers, because there isn't a, it's not using like the Virtual Console settings or anything like that. So you can't pull up like a separate menu or anything. It's just, you're just stuck with what this game gives you, unfortunately. So I just pressed all the triggers and whatnot and nothing happens. But I bet you $20 that I can do a soft reset. Let's see, can I do a soft reset? No, I can't even do the soft reset. Interesting. So it doesn't actually allow you to. Okay, but you can actually press the pause button on the Wii U screen itself and go to continue, restart, and by doing restart, you can go back to the main menu. And wow, doing restart just refreshes it completely, so you completely lose your progress. But what I was going to say is that if you're using some other emulator, like the Wii U Virtual Console or something like that, you can at least like create a save state to where you are. So say if you beat the game and you want to go back and do the second loop later, you can just save state it and then pick it up some other time. So you don't always have to go through and beat the game if you want to access the second loop. But fortunately, getting to the second loop isn't too bad if you know the warp zone trick. As you saw, we beat the game in just about 10 minutes flat, probably close to it. It's a very, very short run if you do the warp zone trick. It's much, much longer if you do the whole game straight through. But I recommend doing the whole game straight through. It's a lot of fun, and it's always a good time. I actually did a full stream of Super Mario Brothers on NES a couple months ago, and then we ended up trying out some ROM hacks. We did the second loop, and that was a good time. And that probably only took us like 2 hours or something like that. I think I was actually struggling to find other things to do by the 2 hour mark on that stream. But yeah, still a good time. Super Mario Brothers is a classic, and Super Luigi Brothers here is a nice twist on things. So again, it's available via the NES Remix pack for Wii U. I don't remember if the original game for NES Remix 2 was DLC or if it was just like a teaser. It might have been a teaser that you had to buy separately, or I don't know. If you guys know for sure, post a comment down below. But on the NES Remix pack, it comes bundled as the full game. On the NES Remix 2 section. So, it's good stuff. And like I said, again, we'll come back sometime for a dedicated live stream of the NES Remix games. We'll try to play through a bunch of the games on the packs. It'll be one of those blind streams I'm going to start doing that should be pretty fun. So I'll basically go into it unpracticed and unfamiliar with it. Especially since it's been like probably 4 years since I actually last dabbled with NES Remix. It should be a good time. So watch out for that sometime, hopefully soon-ish. I'm going to try to mix some things up, do some, less Nintendo properties for the next few weeks. But I'll definitely come back with NES Remix, absolutely, for sure. So definitely watch out for that. So, but alrighty, guys, that's going to do it for me. I hope you guys enjoyed this playthrough. Again, if you're interested in this, it's on the Wii U. It doesn't cost that much. And it's pretty neat. So, but yeah, if you're new to my channel, consider subscribing. If you guys like the video, if you hated it, give it a thumbs up or a big thumbs down. To everyone already supporting my channel, thanks as usual. And I guess until the next one, take it easy.